विष्टुं ज्वलन्तं सर्वतोमुखं नृसिंहं भीषणं भद्रं मृत्युं मृत्युं नमाम्यहम्। Children, in the last class, I have balanced the equation potassium permanganate plus sulfuric acid plus sulfur dioxide. I told you potassium permanganate is an oxidizing agent, is a pink color solution, and sulfur dioxide is a gas. I will show you this reaction. You see the reaction, how the colorless the pink color becomes. That will give you an idea how interesting are the chemical reactions. I will try my best to do all the experiments here and balance the reactions so that you will know that really it is going on, really it is happening. Now I'm showing you the potassium permanganate. This is the potassium permanganate solution, and I am taking the potassium permanganate. You see, this is a pink color solution. This is a potassium permanganate, is a pink color solution. It is a pink color solution. And sulfuric acid is an acid you have read in your school, dilute sulfuric acid, gandhaka amla. Tam padhithilo jeta odia medium school pila mane padhithibo gandhaka amla. So this is a dilute sulfuric acid. I am taking dilute sulfuric acid. Then I have to get sulfur dioxide. But sulfur dioxide gas, I will produce sulfur dioxide and allow the sulfur dioxide to react. So how the sulfur dioxide is produced? So I am doing experiment for potassium permanganate plus dilute sulfuric acid plus sulfur dioxide. I am doing experiment of this reaction, and I'm showing you. So I have this, I will produce sulfur dioxide gas. So how will I get? I will take sodium sulfite, Na2SO3. This is sodium sulfite. When treated with sulfuric acid, S2SO4. So this is sulfate minus 2, hydrogen plus 1. The sulfite minus 2, sodium plus 1. So what will have sodium sulfate? Positive, negative will react. So this will form sodium sulfate and sulfur dioxide plus water. So sulfur dioxide gas will come out. So I will produce sulfur dioxide. Allow that sulfur dioxide to react with potassium permanganate. So what I did, I took sodium sulfite, I treated with sulfuric acid. It forms sodium sulfate, sulfur dioxide plus water. So I will take that sulfur dioxide gas and allow to react with acidified potassium permanganate. As I told you, the redox reaction will wash the reaction. So now I am taking sodium sulfite. Sodium sulfite is a salt, is a colorless salt, is a white colorless salt. This is a white colorless salt. I am taking little of sodium sulfite salt. This is sodium sulfite I have taken. This is sodium sulfite salt I have taken. This is a colorless salt, white, this sea color salt. I am now adding to that sulfuric acid. So you see now the reaction taking place. You see bubbles are coming. Here bubbles are producing. So these bubbles, they are the bubbles of sulfur dioxide. If you inhale, it is a very pungent smell, suffocation, burning. So here is sulfur dioxide gas are coming out. So if you add little more sulfuric acid, you can watch the reaction. Now reaction is going on. You see sulfur dioxide gas is coming out. Sulfur dioxide is producing. So what I am doing now, I am taking potassium permanganate. I am taking a little potassium permanganate. To that I have added sulfuric acid. This is potassium per pink color. Then I am adding sulfuric acid. I added sulfuric acid. This is called acidified potassium permanganate. To this, I am now adding what? Sulfur dioxide. Sulfur dioxide is present in water. So, it is a solution of sulfur dioxide. So, now I am adding to this. See this. You observe this pink color testy. You see the pink color testy. What is going on? You watch. This is sulfur dioxide gas. So, I am adding to this. See what is happening. You watch. Now you see the color of potassium metal slowly is going out. This becomes a little brown. You see little, it was a pink. Now it has become brown. It is becoming brown. Because the valence state was 7. The valence state becomes 5, 6. Then becomes 4. Now pink color gone. It is becoming brown. It is becoming brown. You see it is becoming brown. Then I will add a little more sulfur dioxide to that. Now you see, you will see the brown color, pink color gone. Now this color is what? Brown. Because the valence state is decreasing, so the color is also going on. Then I will add more of sulfur dioxide gas to that. Now see, this becomes totally colorless. This becomes totally colorless. So this is the chemistry. This is called mystery behind the chemical reaction. So this become total colorless. I told you, when I take potassium permanganate, add sulfuric acid, pass sulfur dioxide gas. Sulfur dioxide is a reducing agent. It reduces potassium permanganate to MnSO4. MnSO4 is colorless, hence this change taking place. So let me show this reaction to you. So now you see this is my sulfur dioxide. And I am adding potassium pink color solution. It will be very interesting. The moment the potassium permanganate will come to sulfur dioxide, here is sulfur dioxide gas. The moment this pink color potassium will come to this side, it is becoming colorless, colorless, colorless. See how nicely you will finding this reaction. You see, I am adding potassium. You see, I am adding potassium permanganate to this. You observe to this place. The moment potassium permanganate goes, it is becoming colorless. The potassium permanganate goes, becoming colorless. You see, the potassium permanganate goes, becoming colorless, becoming colorless, becoming colorless. So whole potassium permanganate is going now, that is becoming colorless. It is becoming colorless. So this is the way that if you add this potassium permanganate solution to this sulfur dioxide, it will become immediately colorless. It will lose its color, so sulfur dioxide reduces acidified potassium permanganate. Sulfur dioxide reduces acidified potassium permanganate, hence the pink color changes. So this is a very wonderful reaction. I have shown you, we have done the reaction, we have observed that, and we have balanced this. Now we will take another substance, potassium dichromate, and allow to react it with sulfur dioxide. I will do the reaction. So I'm doing I'm taking potassium dichromate K2CR2O7 potassium dichromate. I'm adding dilute sulfuric acid to that, and I will be passing sulfur dioxide gas through this, and I will do the reaction first. And then I will do the balance, so that you will find what is happening. And that I will write, what compound is formed. And then I will balance the equation. You see, potassium dichromate I have here, it is a orange-yellow color solution. This orange-yellow color solution, I am taking potassium dichromate, is an orange-yellow color solution. Orange-yellow color solution. Potassium dichromate is an orange-yellow color solution. To that, I will add sulfuric acid. I have added sulfuric acid to that. This is called now acidified potassium dichromate. When I add this is acidified potassium dichromate. acidified potassium dichromate. It is an oxidizing agent. The acidified potassium dichromate is an oxidizing agent. Means it is will produce oxygen. I will teach you oxidation reduction. Next class I will teaching you oxidation reduction. Then you will very interestingly understand that what is this. Then what I am doing, I am sulfur dioxide. Now I will produce sulfur. This is now my potassium, acidified potassium dichromate. And I will produce sulfur dioxide gas. And I will allow the sulfur dioxide gas to react. So this is, I have kept potassium dichromate here. This is my sulfuric acid. To this I will add a sodium sulfite. This is my sulfuric acid. To this I will add sodium sulfite. I'll add sodium sulfite to this. So now the reaction is going on. I have written the equation. Sodium sulfite reacts with sulfuric acid to produce sulfur dioxide. So sulfur dioxide, so this reaction I have shown you already. I will take sodium sulfite I am taking. I am treating this with sulfuric acid. So this is producing sodium sulfate and sulfur dioxide plus water. So now the sulfur dioxide and water both are present here. And to this I am adding sulfur dioxide now to whom? To potassium dichromate. What is the color of potassium dichromate? This color is orange yellow. And see what is going to happen. You see, observe this color, change in color. See what is happening now. This potassium dichromate, orange yellow color. I am adding sulfur dioxide gas to that. When I add, you observe what is happening. Slowly, see the potassium dichromate color is changing, going on. Is it vanishing? It is vanishing, color is vanishing. I'll add. Now you see, slowly the orange yellow color is going on. So it is becoming what? Green. This is becoming, you see, down it has become already green. Now, when I will allow the reaction to take place, this become totally green. So this is sulfur dioxide. I have added the potassium dichromate to that. You see, now it has become a green color. I have taken orange yellow color of potassium dichromate. To that, I have added sulfur dioxide. And it formed a green color solution. I will write the reactions for that and balance those chemical equations by partial equation method. Potassium dichromate I have taken, I have added sulfuric acid, that is orange yellow color, then I produce sulfur dioxide gas, allow the sulfur dioxide gas to react with potassium dichromate, it gave me a green, bluish green solution. So why this happens, how this happens, the chemistry of this reaction I will write now. I have done the experiment. I got this result. Now I will write the chemistry behind this reaction. What is happening? So now, same way, the way I have done, this potassium orange yellow color, this potassium dichromate orange yellow color, it is an OA. I am writing OA means oxidizing agent. OA stands for oxidizing agent. Now reaction will balance, will write the product how? Now potassium dichromate K2Cr2O7. How I got this formula? Dichromate Cr2O7 minus 2. Dichromate. This is what? This dichromate. Dichromate. And what is this? Potassium K plus. So what will happen? This dichromate. So this will come to this place, this will go to this place. So the potassium will become what? K2Cr2O7. So this is potassium dichromate, K2Cr2O7. This potassium dichromate. And who are the elements present here? Potassium, chromium, oxygen. If you look to the periodic table, potassium is present in group 1A of the periodic table. I told you it is an alkali metal. In the modern periodic table, group 1A of the periodic table, I have written the periodic table one class while teaching valency. It is valency 1. It is highly electropositive metal. Highly electropositive metal. And chromium. Atomic number 24, chromium, molybdenum, tungsten. They are placed in D block of the periodic table. 6B, I wrote you, chromium, molybdenum, tungsten. Chromium is an electropositive metal. So, and oxygen is a non-metal present in 6A group of the periodic table. It is highly electronegative. This is positive, this is positive, this is negative. So they will react first, produce the product. Those products will react with sulfuric acid and then sulfur dioxide. So potassium will react with oxygen to form what? Potassium oxide. Potassium oxide. Potassium will react with oxygen to potassium oxide. Then chromium will react to oxygen to form chromic oxide Cr2O3. Then rest of O will come out. So potassium oxide is basic. I told you that all electropositive metals react with oxygen to produce their oxides. Their oxides are highly basic. So potassium oxide is strong base. Chromic oxide, now these are also basic. These are also basic. Now we'll balance this. We'll balance this. So how many potassium? K2, K2. Chromium, Cr2, Cr2. O, here 7. We have 7 O. So here 1 O, here 3 O. 3 O plus 1 O, 4 O. So this is 3 O. It is balanced. Now they will react with whom? Then what you have done? We have added sulfuric acid. We have taken potassium dichromate. We added to that sulfuric acid. So that sulfuric acid now will react with whom? Will react with potassium oxide. Will react with whom? With chromic oxide. So K2O plus sulfuric acid, S2SO4. So this is sulfate minus 2, and this hydrogen plus 1, and this oxide minus 2, and this potassium plus 1. So potassium will react with whom? With sulfate to form what? Potassium sulfate. Will form potassium sulfate plus water. Potassium sulfate plus water. It is balanced. Now then Cr2O3. Cr2O3 will react with sulfuric acid. Sulfuric acid. So here chromium is plus 3. And oxygen minus 2, hydrogen plus 1, sulfate minus 2. Chromium plus 3, oxygen minus 2, oxide minus 2, hydrogen plus 1, sulfate minus 2. So chromium plus 3 will react with sulfate to form Cr2SO4 thrice. How I got it? Chromium, its charge is plus 3. Sulfate charge is minus 2. So what will happen? This will come to this place, this will go to this place. So this becomes Cr2 and this becomes sulfate whole thrice. So I got Cr2SO4 thrice plus water. How many chromium? 2 chromium, 2 balanced. How many sulfate this side? 1 sulfate. How many sulfate this side? 3 sulfate. So I multiply this by 3. And how many hydrogen? 6. So I multiply this by 3. It is balanced. I will add. I'll get the equation for this first. Then I'll allow to react sulfur dioxide. So chromic oxide, K2O, K2O, chromic oxide, they cancels. So we got K2, Cr2O7, plus 3 sulfuric acid, 1 sulfuric acid. This is 4 sulfuric acid. 4 sulfuric acid will form K2SO4, Cr2SO4 thrice, plus 3 water, 1 water. This is 4 water, plus 3 O. K2O left side, right side, K2O left side, cancel. Cr2O3 left side, Cr right side, they cancel. So I got K2 Cr2O7 4 sulfuric acid, 3 plus 1, 4 sulfuric acid forms K2SO4, Cr2SO4 thrice, 4 water plus 3O. This acidified potassium dichromate. To that, what I have done, I have taken that, to that I have added sulfur, I have added sodium sulfite. I have added to that sodium sulfite, and the reaction took place to form a green solution. And how this will happen now? Now the sulfur dioxide I have taken, and O, water is present, and I am passing O. Sulfur dioxide, water plus O. This water and O will react, will form what? Sulfuric acid. Sulfuric acid. So, now how many O are here? 3O. How many O? 3O. So, I multiply this equation by 3. Because one sulfur dioxide is reacting with 1O. How many sulfur dioxide? How many O are there? 3O are there. So, whole thing will be thrice. So, 3. So, now I'll take this. So, then what will happen now? I have 4 sulfuric acid right side, and I'll get 3 sulfuric acid left side. So, let me add this. If I add, what I get potassium dichromate K2Cr2O7 plus this gone. Then 3 sulfur dioxide. Then what has happened? How many sulfuric acid? This OO cancels. So how many sulfuric acid right side? One sulfuric acid here. We have 3 sulfuric acid. And how many sulfuric acid right side, left side? 4. So you will have sulfuric acid this side. Left side, I will have 4 sulfuric acid. Right side, I got 3 sulfuric acid. I got 3 sulfuric acid. So this, then what will happen? K2SO4, Cr2SO4 thrice plus water. How many water right side? 4 water. How many water left side? 3. 3 water, 4 water. So we'll have water here. That remains finished. That the total thing. So we got K2SO4, we got Cr2SO4, we got water. So this is the, we got green solution. This color is green, chromic sulfate. Its name is chromic sulfate. Chromic sulfate. This is a green color. And what is this potassium dichromate? This is orange, yellow. So this... Then what has a sulfur dioxide? Reduced potassium dichromate to chromic sulfate. Hence, the orange-yellow color of potassium dichromate changes to green. Changes to green. So, if I write the summary of this reaction, as we'll say, sulfur dioxide, SO2, is a reducing agent. Is a reducing agent, reduces acidified potassium dichromate Cr2O7, acidified potassium dichromate to chromic sulfate Cr2SO4 thrice, chromic sulfate. Hence, the orange yellow color, of potassium dichromate changes to green. The sulfur dioxide, the SO2 is oxidized to sulfuric acid. Sulfur dioxide is becoming sulfuric acid, and potassium dichromate is becoming KrCr2O7. So this is the reaction. These reactions are called as redox reactions. Children, I will be teaching you after this balancing chemical equation. These reactions are called as redox reaction. We have in our second year potassium dichromate, and we have our second year sulfur dioxide. There, when we will read, it will be very easy for us. And in every examination and practical, you have the sulfite radical test. Sulfite radical test. Practical also, you will have this reaction. So, if a student knows how to write the reaction, if a student knows the chemistry behind it, then this reaction, from the very beginning of his career, he feels that I know everything. I know everything. He gets self-confidence. So children, one thing more very important in life, what you know, you should know. And what you know not, should know. What you know not, should know. Then you can know what you know not. Many often we do not do this. The best thing to learn is what? What I know, I should know it. This much I know about it. And also I know at the time what I do not know about it. So when my teacher will teach me, so I will be going on knowing it. But unnecessarily, if I develop a self-complex, then I will not be having anything to learn. I will say, I know it. This is it. So don't skip. I told you in my one day that you have to read in between the lines. When you come from the first line to second line in a paragraph, first line says something, then second line says something. So that gap between them is called the knowledge gap. And we have to cross the knowledge gap. And unless we cross the knowledge gap, we will not add to our knowledge. And if we do not add to our knowledge, our learning is no use. Nobody will teach you again balancing equations. They will tell you, remember, by heart, they will do it. But now, since it's a lockdown period and we have a holidays, college, unfortunately, we are not going to college. We are doing it very slowly. Let us learn. We are learning. Thoraku, thore, padi, tale, chalai, abhyas, sarabale. I told you last class. So just a kid, he starts learning. How? First stands, falls, stands, then falls. Then he gets a way. How to walk, how to stand, then he get the wall. And put the hand on the wall, he feels comfortable. Then, kicking the wall, he walks. Then he starts walking. After walking, he knows tharaku thara pade chale chaloi abhyasara bale. You have to make practice, and you know that practice makes man perfect. Perfection then comes when there is practice. So you have to do that. Unless we do that, we will not gaining the excellence. We will achieve excellence if we proceed. Now, children, we have done three reactions: potassium permanganate plus sulfur dioxide, potassium permanganate, H2S. Then we'll go to another reaction. I will show you today: copper metal with concerned nitric acid. I will show you the reaction. I'll take the copper metal and add to concerned nitric acid and see the reaction. What is going on? And I will write the reaction equation for that, and I will give at last some 3-4 equations to you. You will do them at homework, so that next class I will balance those equations. So I am doing now how the copper will react with concentrated nitric acid. I will show you the reaction. Now I will show you first copper plus sulfuric acid. Copper, let me show you. I have an opportunity now. I have copper with me. I have sulfuric acid with me. What happens to them? Copper is a metal and sulfuric acid is an acid. So I will add copper powder to sulfuric acid. What is happening? Let you see this. You will see, then I will tell you why this is, nothing is happening. You will see, this is sulfuric acid I have taken. And I have now copper powder with me. Copper metal. I have the copper metal with me. These are the copper metal. And this is copper metal I have with me. I am adding to copper metal to sulfuric acid. You see, they went inside. Nothing happened. They remain like that. Air bubbles are coming out, but copper does not react with dilute sulfuric acid. Because all these metals are electropositive. Those metals which are above hydrogen, in the electrochemical series, they displace hydrogen from acid. Copper is below hydrogen in the electrochemical series. So copper will not react with dilute sulfuric acid. It remains like that. Nothing happens. But the moment I take copper, add to concentrated nitric acid. This is my nitric acid. I have taken nitric acid and I will add a little copper. You see, and here what is happening, you see, and why it happened like that, and what are the reaction going on, I will explain you. Now I have taken this concentrated nitric acid and I am adding copper to that. See, so here sulfuric the nitric acid, here I am adding copper. You see what is happening now. See what is happening, you watch. You see here what is happening. You are getting a reaction. You are getting a brown gas. See the brown gas. You are getting what? A brown gas. Reddish brown gas. And what is happening? The reaction taking place. A green solution. And you are seeing the here. And lot of heat is coming out. Lot of heat. If you can, you cannot touch it. A lot of heat. How vigorous is the reaction, you see? You take sulfuric acid, nothing happened. It remained like that. But the moment you took nitric acid, it reacted. So here there is a difference between dilute sulfuric acid and concentrated nitric acid. You see the brown gas. Again, I will add a little more copper to that, and you see the reaction. Now see, again brown gas is coming out. This brown gas is coming from where? From nitric acid. How that gas comes out, that I will explain you. We can very easily see. You see how vigorous is the reaction. You how see how the vigorous is the reaction. So this is the way the reaction is going on. The reaction is going on. How vigorously the reaction is going on. So concentrated nitric acid is reacting with copper, and we get a brown gas here. We got the brown gas here, and we are getting a green solution there. And why this is happening and how the chemical reaction goes on, that I will going to explain you. I will first write the equation, then I will explain you the chemistry behind this reaction. I will first write the equation, then I will write the chemistry behind this reaction. What is nitric acid? Nitric acid is there. Nitric acid there. Is reacting with whom? With copper. What is copper? A metal. What are metals? Electropositive elements. So nitric acid, who are the elements? Hydrogen, nitrogen, oxygen. Nitric acid was sleeping. He was quietly sitting. Nothing was happening in nitric acid. The moment we added, reaction started. Means what? Nitric acid produced its army. When one against party comes, the other party leaves its soldiers. So who are the soldiers present in nitric acid? The soldiers of nitric acid are hydrogen, nitrogen, oxygen. What is hydrogen? Positive. What is nitrogen? Negative. Electronegative element. I told you group 5 of the periodic table have a tendency to take electron to attain octet. So nitrogen, electronegative element. Oxygen, group 6A of the periodic table. Hence it is electronegative. So hydrogen will first react with oxygen. They will produce water. They will produce water. Then brown gas came. This is the brown gas. We have seen the brown gas now. So this is the night. We got the brown gas. Again, I am showing the brown gas. You see, we are seeing the brown gas here. We are getting the brown gas. So brown gas comes means, what is the brown gas? Now brown gas is nitrogen dioxide. That brown gas is what? Nitrogen dioxide. Nitrogen reacts with oxygen to produce what? The nitrogen dioxide, the brown gas, and rest of oxygen comes out. So this is the way the concerned nitric acid reacting. When copper comes at the copper touches nitric acid will leave its soldiers charged. Just like the if you see the fight between students and the police during a strike, then charge the command goes from the magistrate, then all the police people with their lathi, they attack upon the students or the crowd. Exactly same thing happened. The copper came and touched nitric acid. So nitric acid told charge. Then who are the soldiers here? Hydrogen, nitrogen, oxygen. So hydrogen combined with water, hydrogen combined with oxygen to form water, nitrogen formed with nitrogen dioxide. Nitrogen dioxide is a brown gas, came out. Then what happened? Now oxygen came, atomic oxygen. And who is present here? Copper. What is copper? A metal. Copper plus oxygen will form what? Copper oxide. Cupric oxide. Cupric oxide. This cupric oxide is basic. Why? All metallic oxides are basic. I told you acidic oxide, basic oxide, amphoteric oxide, neutral oxide. That is the reason before teaching you balancing chemical equations, I taught you acidic oxide, basic oxide, amphoteric oxide, neutral oxide, so that I can explain you better the balancing chemical equation. So I got copper oxide. So I will balance this equation. First let me balance this. This is a skeleton equation. Let me make it atomic. How many hydrogen are here? 2 hydrogen. So 2 nitric acid. How many nitrogen are here? 2 nitrogen. So 2 nitrogen dioxide. So how many oxygen this side? 6 oxygen. So 1 plus 4. 5, 1, 6 copper oxide. Now copper oxide is metallic oxide. And still nitric acid, all the nitric acid. Now copper oxide is a metallic oxide. Now nitric acid will react. Copper oxide, oxygen is minus 2, copper is plus 2, hydrogen is plus 1, nitrate is minus 1. So copper will react with nitrate to form cupric nitrate, CuNO3 twice plus water. Copper plus 2, nitrate, they will form or cupric nitrate, and hydrogen, oxygen, they form water. So how many nitrate here? 2 nitrate. How many? So we multiply this by 2. Here nitrate 2, so multiply 2. Balance, so hydrogen 2, oxygen balanced. So this, now the reaction is over. So O cancels here. Copper oxide cancels. Then what happened? Copper plus 2HNO3. How many HNO3? 4HNO3. 4HNO3 reacting to form cupric nitrate, that green solution, cupric nitrate plus nitrogen dioxide, brown gas, and two water. So this is the reaction. So you got this green solution. This cupric nitrate is a green solution and this nitrogen dioxide is a brown gas. So you have shown you the reaction. Again you see the reaction. You can very interesting. These are the chemistry children. This is chemistry. If you want to learn chemistry, see them, watch them and learn from it. I am taking nitric acid and I am adding a little copper toning to that. You see, I am adding little copper toning to that. Nothing is very quietly sleeping. The moment copper comes, it wakes up. See, small amount of copper I have added. See the reaction. The solution is becoming, they see here, copper is reacting. Copper is forming copper oxide, then copper oxide is acted upon nitric acid. You add little more, then the reaction is going on. You get the brown gas. The brown gas is nitrogen dioxide. You have, see the bottom, have this green solution, and you have the blue, reddish brown gas. That reddish brown gas is nitrogen dioxide, and this green solution is our cupric nitrate. And this is the way the reaction is going on. This is also a redox reaction because copper is reacting. Copper is exhibiting reducing property. Oxygen here, nitric acid is giving oxygen, so oxidizing agent. And this is also a redox reaction. So this is the way you got the reaction, copper.
So these are called nothing. So what is here? Those metals, which are copper is all the metals. So you have the hydrogen, and above you have the group one elements. Who are they? Now lithium, sodium, potassium. All these are then magnesium, calcium, barium, strontium, zinc, iron. All these are more positive than hydrogen. Who are less positive than hydrogen? Now copper, silver, gold, platinum. They are less positive than hydrogen. So all the metals we classify more positive than hydrogen, less positive. This is called electrochemical series. We call these as electrochemical series. All this we will be reading. Now we are learning the language of chemistry. So electrochemical series. So these metals are, so they will react differently and they will react differently. So what is here copper? Copper is a metal which is below hydrogen in the electrochemical series. So what is the theory behind it? Just I am giving the theory behind it. Those metals which are below hydrogen in electrochemical series. Decompose the oxy acid to produce nascent oxygen, which reacts with metal to produce metallic oxide. The metallic oxides are basic. So react with acid to produce salt and water. Children, this is the sloka that you have to read 4-5 times, so it will becomes yours. And wherever there is this type of reaction comes, copper, silver, gold, platinum, they are below hydrogen. So those metals which are below hydrogen in the electrochemical series decompose the oxidizing acids, you can say. These oxy acids, what? They are oxidizing acids. Okay, now concerned nitric acid, concerned sulfuric acid. The oxidizing acids are who? Now concentrated nitric acid, concentrated sulfuric acid to produce nascent oxygen, then which reacts with metal to produce metallic oxide. The metallic oxides are basic, so react with acid to produce salt and water. So we have taken copper. Copper is below hydrogen in the electrochemical series. So decompose the nitric acid to produce H2O, NO2 and O. You got the nitrogen dioxide gas, brown, reddish brown gas. Then it produced oxygen. Oxygen came. That oxygen is a nascent oxygen, newly burned. Nascent means newly burned. That react with copper to form what? Copper oxide. Copper oxide is a metallic oxide. Metallic oxides are basic oxides. So they react with the acid to produce salt and water. So once we know this theory, let him give any acid, we will write the equation. But if you do not know this theory, you have to remember the reaction. So you, what you know not, first know it. What you know not, you know it, then you can know everything. So this is the way we will do it. Not that I will never be imposing on you any chem equation. Most of the reactions, what I am going to do, what I am going to balance, I will do their reaction here. And I will allow the reaction, I will show you the reaction. And I will balance them. So this is a chapter, copper metal, you have second year. And nitric acid, you have in your first year. Nitric acid, chemistry of first year. And second year, you have copper metal, second year. Now you are completing two reactions. One reaction of second year, one reaction first year. While completing your balancing chemical equation, you are completing your second year chapter something and first year chapter something. So if you possess these ideas, if you possess these things, then that will happen, the correct answer. So children, one thing I want to tell you at the last of the class, knowledge is a synthesis, never an addition one. Knowledge is a synthesis, never an addition one. So if we try to remember them, we are adding it. They will never remain with us. It will go away. Add, 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 fall down, gone. But synthesis means they will go and they will form a new thing. So we read to learn. I told you, we read to learn. By learning, we understand. So we have to go on reading until we understand. And if you have doubt, we will go on asking. Understand. And after understanding, we get the knowledge. The jnana, we'll get it. The rear essence, the marrow of the bone is the knowledge. Marrow of the bone is the knowledge. You got the bone, marrow. So knowledge. And that knowledge then is the synthesizer. You synthesize the knowledge. And that knowledge gives you the wisdom. That is your wisdom and that is your kingdom. You are the king of your wisdom. You are the king of your wisdom. So wisdom is the, just like the kingdom is under the control of king. So king administers over the kingdom of his kingdom. Like this, your wisdom, you will administer your wisdom. Wherever you require, your wisdom will come with you. Whatever questions will come, you will answer. So children, try to read. And while reading, try to learn. And while learning, earn the knowledge, and that knowledge is a synthesized one, will never go from you, and that will add to your wisdom. And any exam you appear, and anything you appear, any test you appear, any question, any interview you appear, you will be in a position, you will have the self-confidence to answer them. So I wish you all best to learn this, on the knowledge and this. So next class again, I will do the balancing chemical equations by partial equation method. Thank you so much for your patience and listening to me.